The heat's up. That means we can all spend more time outdoors. It also means an increase in the risk of coming into contact with creepy crawlies.
You look a bit stressed, Gigi.
I'm feeling a little bit anxious, Tom.
Okay, well, there's a pretty understandable reason because we are surrounded by, I think, the fourth most venomous snake in the world and the fifth. And Mick, you're pretty harmless, Ranger. Mick, good to see you.
You don't
Jury's
bite,
out
Mick.
On that one.
But, nice to see you, but you've brought some friends.
Look, I have, and we've got the whole gambit today. What we've got is some completely harmless things. This is a diamond python, part of the carpet snake family. If you see one of these in your backyard or your shed, this is nothing to be alarmed about. This eats your rats and mice. We recommend if you've got one of those in your environment, try and catch it with a camera. Great experience for your kids. Don't go near it, just leave it to do its thing. Completely harmless. Now, I've got a few other things, not quite as harmless. In fact, we've got death adder here. Mm. Now, the death adder is the fifth most toxic land snake in the world. They're actually quite dangerous because they're ambush feeders. So they cover themselves in dead sticks and leaves. They use the tail as a lure and they strike onto their own tail.
So where in Australia might we come across one of those?
This is the desert specimen, but we find them up and down the east coast of Australia. They're up in the Kimberley region as well. Fairly widely distributed species. And for us, actually very, very interesting species. Now, this one actually works in our anti-venom program at the Reptile Park, so rather than taking lives, this animal has certainly contributed to many, many lives being saved. And so too of the tiger snake that Zach's got over there. He's got it on a hook. That one's a little bit feistier. once again, 300 lives a year are saved by the anti-venom program, so this is one of the snakes that's responsible for that. Tiger snake's got a huge reputation for being very, very aggressive, but like most snakes, very, very shy. A bite is a last resort. And never forget that 80% of all snake bites in Australia, catching or killing the snake that bites you. So if you're not involved in those pursuits, very little chance you're going to get bitten by a snake. Now, something that's a little bit different is the funnel web spider. This time of the year, expecting a little bit of rain. The funnel webs really like the rain. They can become very, very mobile. Oddly enough, the treatment for the bite from both funnel web and venomous snake bite, the management is the same, and I'll show you. We use a bandage like this. This is a 4 metre long, 10 centimetre wide bandage, elasticised. And if you're bitten on the hand, the first thing we do is remove our jewellery because you start to swell up. Actually just hanging on this little one. Now, we then take our bandage. If we haven't got a bandage, makeshift bandage, we tear up any piece of material or clothing. We wrap it around the bite site two or three times, then extend the bandage down towards the end of the limb. We cover the fingers, reverse that bandage and start to head back up again. We're going to use the same tension or tightness that we would use for a sprained wrist. Get to your elbow, don't stop there, right up to the shoulder. Two bandages, whack them both on, then directly to hospital. You don't take off the bandage, medical staff do that. We have an anti-venom for every species of potentially fatal snake in Australia. And in fact, Zach there holding that tiger snake, he heads my venom unit at the Reptile Park, and his responsibility is to milk hundreds upon hundreds of venomous snakes each week to produce the anti-venoms. And each year, about 300 lives are saved by the snake anti-venom program. We also milk funnel web spiders, and about a dozen lives are saved each year as a result of that program as well. So not just a zoo, we do some very, very serious work behind the scenes.
Mm, absolutely.
Now, in the middle here, what I've got a little bit of potential habitat. We can see that funnel web very, very easily, but this is the kind of area they like. So dark, damp, moist, wet, the boggy wet bit of the backyard that never really dries out, that's the place where you're likely to find funnel webs. And in this last little jar here, it might be a bit hard to get a shot of that, we've got a redback spider in there. Now, redbacks have got a huge reputation, but the reality is we haven't had a fatality since 1953. We have very adequate medical products to hasten the cessation of symptoms. It's not quite anti-venom, but we can certainly treat that very, very easily now.
So that's a long time since a fatality from them. Is that because they don't bite that often, or because the treatment is so good?
The treatment is so good now, and the traditional away to get bitten was in the country, outdoor toilet.
It's the dunny, wasn't it?
The dunny. Dad get bitten on the privates, bit embarrassed, didn't say anything, and a week or 10 days later in some very, very serious trouble, and at the time, not a great deal of treatment. So much, much better today. Like anything, if you're going to get bitten or stung by anything, now is the best time.
And where are you likely to come across?
What am I doing now? I'm trying to feed this snake through my belt loop. It's gone through the belt in the back of my pants.
Oh,
there
George.
We go.
Where are you likely to find a redback if it's not in the dunny?
Redbacks like dry areas. They're a dry spider with a dirty web. They don't clean the web. You tend to find them underneath the otto bin, outdoor furniture that's been outside over winter, those sort of places.
In a pair of shoes you might have left outside?
A little pair of shoes. That's more likely to be your funnel web, really.
Oh, is it?
We recommend that if you leave shoes, footwear outside overnight, do the dance of death on it before you put your foot in.
Yeah.
It's a funnel web's
hiding
in
your shoe. Nowhere to go. You put your foot in. Bang.
So when you come, Mick, in the event of coming across a snake like this, your natural instinct is to run.
Yep.
What should you do?
Look, if you're several metres away, certainly running is a very good way to go. You can certainly outrun a snake. If you've done the sort of step over the log and, oh, my gosh, there's a snake right next to you, then it's a bit of grandma's advice. Stay completely still, motionless, and the snake has difficulty differentiating between you and the surrounding environment. You know, you might be a tree, you might be a large rock. It's only when you're moving that you become very threatening. So, and never forget, the venom of the snake has evolved to kill a very small animal very quickly, so a mouse, a rodent, that sort of thing. It'll kill a human, but very slowly. If that snake was to bite Zach, if we elected to do nothing but take scientific notes and observe what happens, about 12 hours before he'd die. So,
you've got 12 hours up your sleeve,
well,
Zach. Don't worry.
And the real point is that it doesn't actually assist the snake at the point of conflict. If anything, it's increased the danger for the snake. You're not going to die instantly, and now he's had physical contact with you. So, bluffing is the way to go.
Yeah, he's chatting.
A lot of people say, oh, the snake attacked me, and when we actually question and we say what happened, and they say it stood up and it hissed. And I said, well, it's actually attracting your attention and it's trying to say, listen, back off now before it gets ugly.
Have you ever been bitten?
I've been bitten by many, many things. I've got most of the alphabet, so to speak. That in the zoo industry, that's what happens. I've even got Q for qual.
you're in character, Mick.
One red belly has bitten me, that's all, and that was a dry bite where she didn't actually inject any venom.
Okay.
And the majority of our snake bites in Australia are dry bites. We're actually very, very lucky.
All right. Wow. Yeah. You are the font of information with the creepy crawlies and the snakes.
Georgie, you made it.
We've made it.
You did indeed.
We have indeed.
Mind holding that for me for a second?
Always happens.
No, he's okay with snakes. You need to get him with a spider. He hates spiders.
Yeah. That's
Mick, great information.
Fantastic.
Thank you so much.
If you want to know more, come up and see us at the Reptile Park. We're always, Zach and I are always there on the weekends. We milk snakes. You can chat to us and more than anything, learn about these animals and learn how to stay safe this summer. Be a bit sensible. That's really the name of the game.
Of course. Mm. Thank you for that, Mick. Well done. All right, Stuart, you all right?
I'm good as gold. I'll give him a little.
He's a good boy.
That's all yours. That is all yours. All righty. He's doing a